Welcome everyone, my name is Brendan Snyder. Thank you so much for joining me. It's with a sad and heavy heart to announce the passing of former Skid Row vocalist Johnny Solinger. He fronted the band for 16 long years and was the longest running vocalist that they had. He did this from 1999 to 2015 and was only recently announced that he had been suffering from liver failure, of which he succumbed to on June 26, 2021 at the young age of only 55. Obviously best known as the vocalist for the reunited lineup of Skid Row. As I said, he joined in 1999, filling the shoes of former vocalist Sebastian Bach, which by no means was an easy task, although I think he did a valiant job at it, putting a nice new spin on the Skid Row material at hand. They first went out on the road, the band themselves, introducing Johnny to the world in 1999, opening up for classic rock legends Kiss. I was lucky enough to see that tour with Skid Row opening, and they did an amazing job. Really whet my appetite for some material by them, which they finally delivered 4 years later. New studio album called Thick Skin, 2003. This was the band's fourth studio album, but it was the first one with Johnny Solinger. I think he sounded great on this album. The material is updated for the new era, but is classically, rooted in the Skid Row vein and style. They did an update or a remake of the song I Remember You, which I think is a nice addition to their catalog, and it's certainly great to hear Johnny Solinger's vocals on it. And what I also really enjoyed was that at the time they had filmed the making of Thick Skin, the album recording process and everything, and released it as a DVD. You know, post-MTV, these bands were not getting a lot of coverage and so forth. And this was a great way to let us fans get to know Johnny Solinger and the new lineup of Skid Row and what they were doing. If you've never seen it, do track it down. It's a great watch. They followed this up in 2006 with Revolutions Per Minute, this time reuniting with original producer Michael Wagner, who had worked with them on their first two albums, the self-titled release and Slave to the Grind, which incidentally is having its 30th anniversary this year. But this particular album was much more raw and varied than previous work. But it also let Johnny Solinger's influences in much more than it had previously, including his country influences. And while interesting though, seeing Skid Row branch out and do this, I don't think it worked as well. This is just my opinion. It is still a solid and good album, but just different. Now, it would be 7 long years before the band would return with new material, this time in the form of a new EP series called United World Rebellion. They released Chapter 1 in 2013. They then followed that up 1 year later, releasing The Rise of the Damnation Army in 2014. So both of these EPs, in my opinion, returned the band to their classic sound, definitely in the vein of Slave to the Grind and Subhuman Race. Unfortunately though, Johnny was let go from the band in 2015. They did not feel that his heart was any longer in the performances, which is understandable. Johnny had always loved country music and was spending more time in that particular genre. In fact, in 2008, he had released his debut solo album, which was a country-influenced album. But if you like what he did with Skid Row, before joining the band, he had another group simply called Solinger, and they released 2 albums and an EP. Starting with this one, a self-titled EP from 1992. So he does go back to the same era as Skid Row. And then a self-titled album in 1995, which is absolutely excellent. But my favorite of all of these, Chain Link Fence from 1999, definitely in the vein of Skid Row's Subhuman Race, that heavier edged sound. You know, Johnny did release one last recording in January of 2020. It was a new country single called Texas When I Die. And unfortunately, that looks to be the last recording. I hope there is some stuff in the catalog, you know, the archives that we can get at some point. But with his passing on June 26th at only the age of 55, it certainly came as quite a shock. Simply just too soon for a great rocker like Johnny, who had so much life left in him. He will certainly be missed, but obviously not forgotten. Let's all celebrate Johnny's life and enjoy our favorite recordings by him. Rest in peace, Johnny. you will be missed. Thank you, everyone. Please leave your comments and your thoughts regarding Johnny and his band, or when he was with Skid Row, and certainly his solo recordings and all of that great stuff in the comments section below. And certainly have a great day, everyone. Take care. And Johnny, you will be missed. Bye-bye.